Project Lakota Sikhas, Parshas Nayach, Sikha Aleph.
Hashem commanded Nayach to build a teva so that the wicked people of his generation would do teshuva. Nayach did what Hashem did ask. He spent 120 years on this hard task. But he wasn't ready to go the extra mile, to do Hashem's will with excitement and a smile. The Teva was a place of peace and safety, but there was no benefit for his community. Therefore, he couldn't hire a construction crew. It was a mitzvah that he had to do. On the other hand, we find Moshe Rabbeinu, who was so caring and kind. When the Yidden sinned with the golden calf and Hashem got angry, Moshe said, "If you destroy my people, erase me from your Torah completely." Although what the Yidden did wasn't right, Moshe fought to save them with all his might. Not only was Moshe a devoted leader, but all Yidden cared for one another. Because after the giving of the Torah, the world was not the same. United as one, man with one heart, the Yidden became. About ourselves, we don't just worry. To protect another Jew is our responsibility. Just like the Teva protected Nayach and his family, in the desert, Hashem protected the Yidden with clouds of glory. We build sukkahs to remember Hashem's protection. Every Jew is welcomed, and it is as if it is my sukkah belongs to him. Here is a sukkah story to show that the extra mile a Yid will go. His caring action is like a shining star, which has an amazing ripple effect on those near and far. In the shul of Rabbi Elimelech of Luzhinsk, there was a festive atmosphere. Rabbi Elimelech smelled the smell of Gan Eden in the air. When davening was done with Rabbi Zusha, his brother, a Gan Eden smelling esrog they did discover. They asked Uri, the esrog's owner, to please tell them his story. He began by telling them that although he was poor, he saved half of his money to buy a beautiful esrog each year to fulfill the mitzvah of Lulav and esrog, which he held so dear. "I was on my way to buy an esrog when I stopped at an inn to rest. I saw a Jew crying who was obviously distressed. His horse, which he used to make a living, was weak and about to die. How will I provide for my family now?" he did cry. The innkeeper tried to be nice. He offered to sell one of his horses for 50 rubles, which was a good price. But the poor Yid had no money to pay. "Since I had 50 rubles, I came forward right away." To sell the horse for 45 rubles, the innkeeper did agree. "With the remaining 5 rubles, I brought this plain esrog, which you see," Rabbi Elimelech said. "Now we understand why your esrog smells so great. The rest of the story to you I will relate." On the night of Yom Kippur, to judge the Yidden, Hashem was getting ready. Rabbi Levi Yitzchak of Bartichev was pushing a wagon of mitzvah so heavy. My brother Rabbi Zusha and I tried to help him, but the wagon wasn't moving, because in the way there were piles of averis that the satan was putting. Suddenly, the poor man who thought you were Eliyahu Navi cried with all his might, "Hashem, thank you for helping me. I don't know how to pray, it is true, but I will crack my whip in the air 3 times as a sign of my love to you." The cracking of the whip caused the wagon of the mitzvahs to move right away and flatten the averis that were blocking the way. Hashem then sealed all the Yidden for a healthy and happy sweet new year, because you showered a Jew in need with love and care.